one important question people say that, you know, I'm not so good at memorizing and mugging up, so can I crack this exam? Most students are familiar with this idea, right? Rote learning, we've done it in school, colleges, vomited things out. We will vomit out some lines from a topper's note or guidebooks, okay? And we'll write long answers, fill up the whole sheet on the day of the exam so that examiner knows that we've done hard work. Whether we are answering to the point doesn't matter. A lot of things we have written, right? Now, often students, while starting their journey exam or their judiciary preparation, they will stick to the same thought process. They will not realize that, oh, my method that I use for college exam, college learning is not workable, because judiciary exam requires to do certain different things and they're always evolving. Okay. So it is a myth that you have to memorize notes to crack this exam. It's not true. Most people who try to mug up, they will fail. There are tens of thousands of candidates writing this exam and hundreds and thousands may go to the same coaching class. You can't set yourself apart by vomiting notes of a judiciary coaching. Something else is needed. If you focus on cramming, you will have a lot of difficulties answering variations. Like, I give you one question on free consent. After that, what will happen? I'll give you a small variation. Okay, some type B question. But you won't be able to answer it because you marked a different answer up. In fact, the answer won't even strike you, right? So, and application-based questions, so you will never be able to answer if you are mugging up. Okay, so this is very important to know. Your retention will be lower. If you are mugging up, you will not be able to recall the answers. So every 2 weeks, you'll find yourself revising the old stuff and you can't study the new stuff because you've forgotten the old stuff. Okay, and you will spend a lot of time in revision. Cramming is mugging up. Ratta marna. Okay, I don't know, whichever way you thought of it. You know, you just learn up everything blindly that way. It's critical to develop a conceptual and practical understanding of bare acts, materials, all of that, because selection boards know that, you know, they are making papers which are harder to crack by just using notes or by mugging up the material. You have to apply things, and that's how the papers are also changing. Okay, Delhi Judicial Services is an example, and a lot of other states are borrowing that kind of style. Okay, so you need to be basically good with your conceptual understanding. Okay, word-to-word memorization is not the key here. Conceptual understanding and practical application is the key. Okay, so they are asking you questions based on latest case laws, which a coaching could not have been covered, for example. If you focus on rote learning, you will find it difficult to go past interview stage. Maximum you can do is clear mains. That also is very difficult. But in interview stage, they are specifically testing for this, that, you know, is your understanding go, articulation of law, all of that is clear or not. Okay. And you are likely to struggle with cracking the interview and mains if you do that. Okay. Many students make the mistake. What they say, oh, practice karna hai. Okay. I'll practice. So I'll mug up everything and practice again and again. That's not what practice means. You don't have to cram it up. Okay. You succeed when you practice writing the answers, taking mocks, and get a lot of feedback. But that's got nothing to do with remembering by mind exact word to word, all of that. Okay. Some people believe that if they have learned the answer, they are well prepared. Okay. Like I studied, you know, that case law I taught right now. So you've learned it, now you're prepared. Okay. That's what you would think, right? No, that's not the case. They are in for a rude shock at the exam. Knowing the answer in your head is not enough. You have to be able to write it. I will know that you are prepared for mains only when you can write at least 3-4 questions on Vinay Sharma. You can write in 500, 800 words. You can attempt a few MCQs. If you get those questions right, I know that you know what Vinay Sharma did. Okay, but otherwise you won't know. Okay. So this is a skill that you can perfect with practice, not by saying that, oh, I think I know it in my mind. And that is top reason for failing. Okay. And get a lot of feedback on it. Because if there are 5,000 here, if I ask you for your answers, each one of you will write different answers. So whose answer is correct? Whose answer is better? You need feedback on that, right? That is what will happen. Some state exams like Delhi Judicial Services will give you a lot of questions on original analysis. And you really can't do this without a conceptual and practical understanding. And others are also borrowing this because And what will happen? The examiner will see now that who has a better, more sound conceptual understanding, who is writing new points than what is only written in the dukki or in the little commentary. Okay, so that will stand out in your mains exam, that will stand out in your interview.